Today, I'm going to introduce you to an awesome spelling game that you can play with a class or a small group. It's the perfect game to warm up before a spelling lesson or for a bit of fun at the end of the school day. In fact, this game is so much fun that I remember playing it when I was at school. So, let's play the spelling game. Firstly, divide the class into five roughly equal groups and nominate one person in each group to be a captain. These five captains are the only people allowed to communicate with the teacher on behalf of their group. Each team starts with 5 points. Now, the aim of the spelling game is to keep building towards a word one letter at a time without being the team to finish a word. It's actually quite difficult to explain how the game works, so the best way to learn the rules is by looking at a few examples. The teacher randomly chooses a starting team. In our game, Team 1 is going to start. After a brief, whispered discussion with their teammates, the captain of Team 1 announces the letter R. The teacher records the letter for the whole class to see. Oh wait, that's me. Play continues to Team 2, and after a brief discussion, the captain says the letter A. Again, the teacher writes it down. Remember, the aim of the game is to keep the letters growing for as long as possible, without being the team to finish a word. The captain from Team 3 consults their teammates, and they decide on the letter I. Now we have the letters R, A, I. And we're getting close to finishing a word, so Team 4 need to be careful. Without consulting their team, the captain from Team 4 announces the letter N. Unfortunately, they have spelt the word rain, R-A-I-N. It pays to talk to your teammates before committing to a letter. In this case, Team 4 lose a point. Can you think of a letter instead of N that Team 4 could have said to keep the word growing? Let's have a look at one more round. Play starts with the next team, which is Team 5. Their captain announces the letter B. Now, play continues back to Team 1, and their captain announces the letter E. Now, it's worth mentioning here that B-E spells the word B. However, when playing the spelling game, we don't count two or three letter words as finished words. So, play continues to Team 2. The captain from Team 2 tries something a little tricky and announces the letter H. The play moves to Team 3. Now, Team 3 are a little confused. They can't think of any words that begin with the letters B, E, H, so they announce a challenge. Play returns to Team 2. They have been issued with a challenge by Team 3 and must announce and spell a word starting with B, E, H, or they will lose a point. The captain from Team 2 announces the word behave, B, E, H, A-V-E. In this instance, Team 3 have unfortunately had their challenge defeated, and therefore lose a point. If Team 2 were not able to come up with a word and the challenge was successful, then they would lose the point instead. So, those are the basic rules of the spelling game. If your team doesn't think the team before you can finish spelling a word, then you can challenge them. Now, another piece of advice. If your team is clearly stuck and has no option but to finish a word, you might try bluffing the next team by announcing a letter really confidently. Sometimes this strategy convinces the next team that you know a word that they don't. A couple of other rules to keep the game moving smoothly. As mentioned, two and three letter words do not count as completed words. Proper nouns, such as names and countries, are not included in the spelling game. You can't use the same starting letter twice in a game. And lastly, if Team 2 challenges Team 1, then Team 3 starts the next round, regardless of the result of the challenge. The winning team overall is the one with the most remaining points at the end of the lesson, or when the bell rings. We hope you have an awesome time playing the spelling game. Let us know of any house rules or modifications you come up with in your class. We'll see you next time. Hey there. If you like what we do here at Teach Wonderful, make sure to subscribe to our channel. You'll also find plenty of amazing teaching ideas, student worksheets, and merch over at teachwonderful.com. Thanks for watching. We'll see you soon.